Hello everyone, Rob Pilger here, and this is my new video, Gym Notes Diary. And I'm going to talk to you tonight about a thing that many students fail to understand is we become our habits in training. And what I'm talking to you about tonight is I had a couple new fighters in there sparring tonight. They've been sparring, just for like a month now, month and a half. But they failed to understand, like tonight when they got tired, is they started to really show the fatigue and not stay composed. And you just can't obviously do that because you revive another fighter in that ring and it looks bad to the judges in the fight and it looks bad, period. But if you watch those guys, now when I watch them, I make sure they don't do that. But when they work on their own or if I'm on the other side of the gym, you know, they'll start to get kind of, their body language will start to drop on the heavy bags. And you can't do that. Obviously, that you're instilling a bad habit there. So one thing to understand is when nobody's around and you're doing your extra workouts, or even when you do get tired on the bag when you're in a class in the gym setting, that's the last thing you want to do. Is once you start to get tired, that's where the true training starts, is keeping your composure. Your body language is everything. You know, in life, obviously, and in the ring, more importantly, you can revive a motherfucker so quick when you do that. And when you're on the heavy bags, as soon as you start to fatigue, that's when you really gotta, that's the mental training there. That's when you really gotta up it. And sparring is the real world. Any asshole can look good on the heavy bags, on the speed bag, on the double M bags. They don't hit back. That don't mean jack shit, obviously. But in sparring, the truth comes out. In sparring, you really find out, from a trainer standpoint, what kind of fighter you have. And in sparring, you find out what kind of fighter you are. So you become your habit. So make damn sure when you're training, when you're doing your extra workouts, or when you are in the gym with the other fighters and your trainer, you stay focused. And as you fatigue, you know, fatigue makes cowards of men. Keep that in your mind if you're a fighter out there listening to this, and that you up your game. You keep your elbows into your body. You keep your chin tucked. You keep your hands up. You keep moving. You don't get sloppy. Because when it comes time to spar, the truth's gonna come out. And you know, and when you're in a real fight, it's like in sparring. What you do in sparring is what you're gonna carry into the ring. And that's the last thing you wanna do in a close fight, is to make these mistakes and to get sloppy and to get tired. You get sloppy, so you're gonna get caught. You're giving that guy all these advantages. But once you start to get tired, if you can't keep your composure and you can't keep your poker face, the other guy's dog tired, you're reviving his ass, and that could very well cost you the fight. So remember that, even, you know, when you're dog tired on the heavy bags, do one more round. Do one more round just to work on keeping your composure, just keeping your hands up. You get dead tired after, you know, working the double M bag, or after doing, you know, five rounds on the heavy bag, six rounds, and you want to sit down and take a round off or just call it a day. Do one more round to stay composed, just playing that mental game, acting like you're in a fight, acting like this heavy bag there is an opponent ready to smoke you, ready to beat your ass. And you work on staying tight as possible, as far as tight as possible with a tight defense. Do that, and your longevity is going to be increased. And do that, and your coach is going to love you more in sparring. And do that, and you're going to start dominating more fighters in sparring. You do that, and you're going to start winning more fights, which is the most important thing.